Replacing a vinyl window can be difficult if you don't know how to do it. In this video, we're going to show you how to replace an old vinyl window with a new one.
If you rip the stitches like this that cause the dodger to bend down over the bow, you'll be able to flatten out the front panel. If you don't rip the stitches, then everything will be bunched up like this, and you won't be able to get the window on accurately. So rip the stitches. It's a simple process. If you turn the cover inside out, you'll probably have to pick each stitch with a seam ripper if it's a straight stitched dodger, but that's no problem. Just takes a little time. And then when we're done replacing the window, we'll reattach everything and sew it back the way it was. Window material ages, it loses its plasticizers, and that causes it to harden. You can see some of these edges have begun to curl and harden. If they cause trouble, this one's not terribly bad, but if you have a spot that's badly creased, you might even have a tear, and it'll be difficult to get that to lay flat. You can just cut it out locally. I'm going to cut these edges away.
This window was put in a little bit oversized. That's why Jim's going to cut the excess material off. It's not needed.
New window over the old. I'm going to attach the new window material, which is right here, over the top of the old one. I'm not going to cut the old window out. I'm going to leave it in place. Just flatten it as much as I can. Use basting tape all the way around the edge. Cut the new window. Put it over the top of the old one. And then I'm going to turn the dodger over, and with a seam ripper, you'll see it in just a moment, we'll cut away the new window, and that'll leave it trimmed just as it was originally. We won't have to worry about anything on the outside of the dodger. It'll have its original trim. The reason to use crystal clear here is that this dodger only has a limited life anyway, so the durability that you get, the extra durability that you get with the Stratoglass is probably not necessary with most replacement work. Notice that there's a piece of paper that is interleaved as the sheet goods are rolled. That keeps them from scratching. And you do have to be somewhat careful as you work with this stuff because you can scratch it. Not that it's the end of the world if it's scratched, but it's still something to be careful about. First, I need to trim away this roll that's going to cause problems. I'm just trimming this away because it's hardened and it'll make it difficult to lay the new piece flat on the old. So I'm laying the window down. I'm not going to make the new window as big as the old. There was plenty of excess on this old window. All I need is enough to get a good stitch, 3/4 of an inch or so inside the edge. I'm going to use a chalk pencil to make my marks. I don't have to be terribly careful here. Just put some lines down. I can use the edge of the fabric for that. And like that. And well, this is 30 thousandths, but 40 thousandths cuts just as well. And of course these edges don't need to be sealed. Once they're cut, they're not going to ravel. I'm going to cut that from the other end. All right, my window's cut now. I'm going to turn it over and I'm going to put basting tape all along the edge of the window. I'm using part number 129. It's a common tape that we've used for many years here at Sailrite. Since we're sticking window material to window material, there won't be really any need for a special adhesive. This stuff sticks very well to the plastic. Notice that I cut it simply by pulling it apart. That gives me an easy way to peel the paper backing off. I don't have to work to split the two layers as I would if I made a clean cut with a pair of scissors.
Jim now peels off the paper backing on the seam stick to reveal the glue.
Okay. So once again, we're working on the inside of the Dodger. We're placing the window on top of the old window, making sure that everything is flat underneath. As we work, we're spreading out the old window material. I want to keep it as accurate as possible. Because this is a vinyl to vinyl adhesive bond, it'll stick very well. And we shouldn't have any trouble with it coming apart as we sew it. Okay, our new window's in place right on top of the old window. I'm ready to sew along the edge first and get that all sewn solidly. And then I'm going to move over and sew the inside edge. This one will be held in place, and I'll sew parallel so I'll be able to roll this up. And then I'll complete the sewing by doing the ends of the windows. I'm going to put my stitch right on top, or just slightly outside, of the original stitch that was used to hold the window in place. And each stitch will start with a short forward and a short reverse, so I can lock those stitches in place. I'm sewing at maximum stitched length, and I'm in a straight stitch. Doesn't have to be straight stitch, but it'll look a little better, I think, on this Dodger. It was done with straight stitch originally. All right, and I've reached the end. I'm going to do my reverse for just a short stretch so that it locks everything in place. And now I'm going to skip over to the next window. And once again, I'll do a short forward and reverse. Now I've got a little bit of a turn here. I'm going to bury my needle and rotate the whole panel. Wasn't much of a turn. All right, I'm going to bury my needle and now get myself straightened away for this stitch. I'm very close to the edge thanks to the fact that we ripped the seam here. So I'm going to sew as far as I can. When I get to this point where I've got all this cloth, I could wad this up and feed it through the machine. Indeed, I think I'll do that because it's going to take less bulk than the window material. So. I'm not going to slice into my new window, and I've just squeezed this together so that I could get through the old window but not the new. And now I'm going to work all the way around.
Jim's cutting out the old window with a seam ripper. You can also use scissors, but you do have to be careful not to scratch or cut the glass that is new underneath. Now here it is with the old window removed and the new window in its place. Looks great. All window panes have now been basted and sewn in place. Now Jim's reattaching those seams that he ripped in order for those windows to lay flat, and he uses double-sided tape to again baste those and hold them in place. We're using a stapler here to make sure that this panel does not come apart when we take it over and sew. He's basted it all in place. As you can see here in the video, we're just sewing that panel that we ripped apart to ensure that the window would go on flat now with a straight stitch all the way down its length. And then at the end, we do some reversing to lock the stitch in place. And you are done once you do that to the other side as well or anywhere else you ripped it up. Here's what those Dodger windows look like when it's up on the boat. Now, we haven't snapped it down thoroughly all the way around, but those windows really make it look beautiful from what it looked like before. I'm Eric Grant with Sailrite, and thanks for watching.